Hey guys, today's video is about Intuitive Surgical, ticker symbol ISRG on the stock exchange. This is what happened to the stock price over time, and I think they still have lots of room to grow. Intuitive is a technology company that develops, manufactures, and markets surgical solutions and technologies through robotic assistance. They are already a big company with a market cap of $98 billion and trade at a price-to-earnings ratio of 85 times. Gross margin is 66%, which is a strong sign that this company has competitive advantages, and net margin is 26%. Liabilities are under control with almost no debt and lots in cash. The company was founded in 1995 with a very backyard company look. In 2000, they launched the first version of what would become the company's flagship, the Da Vinci Surgical System, a robot that helps physicians perform minimally invasive surgical procedures. The company was a pioneer, and today they have decades of experience, always bringing innovation and cutting-edge technology. The company is headquartered in California, and they are present in 50 American states. The company's robots are sold to 67 countries worldwide, with more than 5,900 robots currently in operation, 70% of them in the US, 15% in Europe, and 10% in Asia. Those robots that the company began to build in the early 2000s are today the most modern and sophisticated robots when it comes to minimally invasive surgeries with robotic assistance. They have four arms, one of which carries the camera that delivers the images to the surgeon, while the other three are free to carry surgical instruments such as tweezers and scissors. The robot brings several benefits to the surgeon, and there's a video of the company on the internet that became viral. It shows the robot stitching grape skin back on to demonstrate its precision and ability to perform delicate movements. The surgeon stays positioned like this, watching high-definition 3D images, and can comfortably control the arms of the robot. With that, the doctor has a very high-quality view of the procedure on the monitor, and the robot arms can be extremely precise, avoiding tremors that would be caused by the surgeon's human hand. In this graph, we can see on the left side how much the company has grown, an average of 18% from 2014 to 2019. The company still haven't presented a graph like this with numbers for 2020, but we'll have a look at that in a minute. And on the right side, we can see how the number of procedures with the assistance of Da Vinci systems have increased, as have the areas in which it can be used. Obviously, these robots are very expensive. Each one of them costs from $0.5 to $2.5 million on average, so it's clear that this limits the company's growth a little bit, because not all hospitals will be able to count on one or more than one of the company's robots. But they have a very interesting competitive advantage that guarantees a certain predictability for the business. 72% of revenue is recurrent, because after buying the robot, the company continues to sell the instruments that need to be replaced. Innovation for them is a fundamental issue. They need to be up to date at all times and ahead of competitors. With that in mind, the company has recently developed the ION system, a device that helps in the performance of lung biopsy procedures, and the Da Vinci SP, which enables the performance of non-invasive procedures that until recently could not be performed with the assistance of robots. The manufacturing process of the robots and instruments is basically divided into three categories. Da Vinci robots are made 100% in the US, some in California and the rest in North Carolina. The medical instruments that the robot uses are manufactured in California and in a unit that the company owns in Mexico. and the specific equipment for endoscopy is manufactured both in the US and in a unit that the company acquired in Germany in 2019. In 2020, the company ended up suffering as a result of the pandemic. Most of the surgeries that robots perform are elective, and as we know, hospitals around the world ended up centralizing efforts to fight the pandemic. With that, almost all elective surgeries ended up being postponed. As a result, the number of procedures had a sharp drop from March 2020. This obviously affected the results in 2020, but now with the pandemic a little bit more under control, the company is gradually returning to pre-pandemic numbers. In the first quarter of 2021, the number of procedures grew 16% compared to the previous year, the number of Da Vinci systems shipped increased 26%, and with all that, revenue was up 18%. As the company said, the surgeries that were postponed are elective, not optional. This means that sooner or later, most patients who had to wait will end up undergoing surgical procedures. Here we can see the numbers of the company in 2020. There were more than 1.2 million procedures and 936 Da Vinci systems placed. Every 25 seconds, a Da Vinci robot procedure is performed around the globe. So we're talking about a company with very innovative and promising products, no debt, excellent margins. So here's my thoughts on the company. They are the pioneers in robotic-assisted surgeries with cutting-edge technology, 72% of recurring revenue. They are financially strong with almost no debt. They historically also generate value to shareholders through the repurchase of shares and have a very interesting moat because they are in a sector that is intensive in capital and in research and development. It's not like other companies can get there and start manufacturing robots at this level. They need lots of cash and years of research and development to get where Intuitive is today. And they also have the possibility to grow internationally since their revenue is very much based on the American market. When it comes to the weaknesses and risks, we can highlight the price of the robots, which cost from $0.5 to $2.5 million, and this might end up restricting growth a little bit. There's also the chance of a competitor being able to present more technological, more innovative, and also cheaper robots in the future, so that's another thing to keep in mind. So, what do you think? Is Intuitive a stock to buy and hold? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to smash the like button and subscribe to the channel for videos of some of the greatest companies to invest. See you next time.